Welcome back, this is Kukicher for a Vintage Lego Town Set review for you guys. And this set number 6563, the Gator Landing. So this set came out in 1996 and it has 233 pieces and 3 minifigures. And this is what you get. We get the water plane, we get the hovercraft, we get the swamp boat, we get a jeep, and we get the hut. And you can open the door there. And not a whole lot going on in the back, you only get that seat there, and there's a jeep. And we have the doors which you can open up, and you can open the skylight and get access to the driver and the steering wheel. And we get a walkie-talkie and the axe. So very fun looking build there. And here is the swamp boat, which has a propeller which spins 460. It will not float, but it will break very easy. So, but yes, this is what Lego did back in the day. And there's the water plane. We get the propellers there, which spin 460. We get the pontoons there. The windshield opens up, and you get nice cockpits there. And we get some cash there, which is in a way, and some brown on my two tiles, which could be chocolate maybe. And here we get the two suitcases, which are stuck in there very, very well there. But yes, this is definitely a very swooshable plane, and it's a lot of fun to build and to play with, and it looks very interesting. It will not float though, but it's still very cool, and it doesn't matter if it's loading or not. I think it's very, very fun, and it's also very nostalgic if you ask me. There's another look at the hut. It might be very flimsy by that bridge there, so keep in mind. Keep that in mind once you are picking this set up, because it could break very easy once you pick it up, and that break that bridge will fall off very easy. There's the plane again. Yes, this is definitely a good set for its day, and I think my favorite part about the set is definitely the water plane, because this is a lot of fun to play around with for sure. And the second favorite part, probably the jeep, and then I will go for the hut, and then for the swamp boat. And there's the jeep, so that's a lot of fun to look at and to play around with and to add to your Lego city. The swamp boat has some nice building going on there. As I said, it can break very easy, but we also get the pickaxe and the ore there in case something happens. Well, some alligator actually shows up at the swamp and we need to defend. So probably this is why we have the pickaxe. And yes, we have the cactus there, and we get the alligator. You can open the mouth and move the tail around. And then we get to the minifigures next. And if you want me to do more Lego Town videos, definitely subscribe to my channel, hit the bell for notifications, like this video, and share this video with social media platforms. That way you won't miss anything in the future. And I will be doing more videos in the future. Like the speed build, if it's not uploaded yet, it will be uploaded very, very shortly. So stay around, because you probably want to watch that. And here's the first minifigure, and here's the cowboy hat and the life jacket and the black sunglasses, and of course here's a green vest going on, and some white shirt and the blue jeans. There we have another version of Maniac for Bricks, this time with red pants and a red cap. And he has the eyebrows. So there is the figure we get with the set. And there is the figure without the head. And lastly, we get to the third figure with the very, very cool sunglasses in blue, and he comes with the stubbles there. And he has the black hair and the gray pants. And he has the brown jacket. And once you remove his hair, this is what you see. Backprinting hasn't been around by that time, but that doesn't really matter. I think that's very nostalgic, especially since this is the older brown and the older gray colors, which LEGO actually used to have in this set. And there's instruction, no mistakes, no mispieces. We also get alternate builds with this set. And if you want me to build them at some point in the future, definitely let me know in the comment section down below, because they're a little bit harder to build and you don't get instructions for those. So you only have to look at the pictures, and that could be very challenging because you don't know where the parts actually go. So that's a lot of fun, but also could be very frustrating if you get it wrong. But yeah, this is definitely a fun set to have, and I like that a lot, and it's a nice addition to a LEGO City. And this is why you should get the Gator Landing. Very nostalgic set from the past.